Kind of unlike any other fresh, juicy green scent that I've tried recently. Hey, what's up guys, it's Josh here. I just want to do a little review today on a fragrance called Armav Hunter. Now, if you've been watching my channel, I've been really highly hyping the Armav's Hunter Intense. This is kind of the one that gets a lot of hype in the community. One of my subscribers a while ago, so I was like, I'm surprised that you like Hunter Intense so much. You're not trying the original Hunter. One of my popular series is top 10 favorite Armav. So it's interesting for me to try out other fragrances, try out weird ones that people haven't really explored too much and see if I can find any hidden gems. This one isn't really hyped too much. And the only fragrance that this really reminded me of is a fragrance by Abercrombie & Fitch called Revival. Now discontinued. It was kind of like this fruity, spicy kind of scent. The main notes in this one are grapefruit, lang lang, tuberose, cedar needles, rosemary, and sandalwood. So some notes that you're not usually typically seeing in some sort of like a fresh fragrance. To me, this is a very fresh, very juicy green style fragrance. Like it's right down the middle green, but at the same time, it doesn't smell like so many familiar green style scents. It does not smell like a green apple. It doesn't smell like Millesime Imperial. It doesn't really smell like Lucky You. There's so many different green style fragrances that are just so generic that this doesn't smell like. At the same time, it's not really groundbreaking. It's not like the most unique thing you've ever smelled, but there's aspects to it that just are different from other fragrances out there. And I remember somebody on Fragrantica saying, this is heavy on the Lang Lang. I don't have too much experience with smelling Lang Lang by itself. I know that Lang Lang is used in virgin almond water and I really enjoy it. I wrote up pros, I wrote up cons, and then I gave it a full rating. So let's jump right into the pros of this fragrance. The pros is that it's got this likable, fresh, juicy vibe, like undeniably juicy when you spray this fragrance. I do also like that it doesn't smell 100% like a DNA of another fragrance. It doesn't smell like it's using 100% or even parts of another DNA where they tuned it up. This totally smells kind of unlike any other fresh, juicy green scent that I've tried recently. It has certain characteristics that are similar to Armav's Hunter Intense, being that it's a little bit different. It is fresh and it's borderline rough, but at the same time, if you spray like one or two sprays, it's not going to be rough. It's going to be probably pretty smooth and enjoyable. These two fragrances are very, very, very different in my opinion. It's familiar yet different. It also has a very, very cheap price. That's pretty much the pros that I could give it for. It smells pretty good. It smells a little different. It's fresh, juicy, and it's got a very, very cheap price. Those are the pros to this fragrance. The cons to this fragrance, there is a few. When you spray this one, a lot of sprays, for some reason, it has this weird, earthy, viney kind of smell that comes out to it. It's kind of weird because every time that I've sprayed this fragrance one time, all it smells like is fresh and juicy. But when I overspray it, there's a little bit of this slightly unpleasant viney quality. It's hard for me to like pinpoint what it is. Maybe it's the Lang Lang, but that comes out and it definitely makes it a little bit less easy to like. It's hard to explain, but it's only when you spray it a lot. If you just spray this kind of mildly, you're gonna avoid a little bit of that weird roughness. I can't really compare the roughness to any other things from Armav. It's not really like the roughness of Club de Nuit Intense Man. It's not really like the roughness of Armav's Derby Clubhouse Silver, or Derby Clubhouse Blanche. It's its own kind of weird roughness. It's not too bad. It doesn't kill the fragrance, but it does show itself when you spray a lot of sprays. It's about an average projector. It doesn't project like insane amounts, but I would say it's solidly above average as far as projection goes. And I was just saying, if you spray it a lot, it can be overdone. So it's got decent projection. It doesn't have beast mode projection. That's really the only cons that I could come up with it. This fragrance is really right down the middle for me. If I had to redo my top 10 Armav fragrances, this might be number 9 or 10. It might bump out Club de Nuit Man. If I were to give it a smell rating, in between a 7.5 to an 8 seems good for this fragrance. A 7.5 kind of seemed low, but an 8 kind of seemed a little bit high, because when I give rate fragrances an 8, there's a lot of aspects that I really, really like. So between 7.5 to an 8 for the smell for me personally. And then the likability, 7.5 to an 8 too. It's not a tried and true scent. It's not for sure gonna deliver compliments. It's not like the most sexiest thing that I've ever smelled, but it is generally likable. It has that fresh, juicy vibe that I like and is a little bit different. Like I was saying, it doesn't smell 100% like a lot of other green fragrances out there. For the projection, I'd probably give it a 7 to a 7.5. This one has solid above average projection, maybe even just a 7.5, because it is really, really solid, well above average. It's not gonna be insane, it's not gonna be beast mode, but it's gonna be very solid right down the middle. I would say if you guys wanna check out a somewhat different green fresh scent from Armav, I would say check it out. It's pretty solid, and it's probably going to be at the tail end of my top 10 Armavs. I guess if you want something more tried and true, I would probably still stick with Hunter Intense. Although it's really nice having this original Hunter because nothing really smells like it in the Armav line. Armav likes to take a lot of different fragrance DNAs and just kind of barely change them, so you end up having a lot of different fragrances that all kind of smell the same. This one really did its own thing, and I appreciate it for that. But anyways, guys, let me know if you've tried Hunter. Let me know if you tried Hunter Intense. Let me know what you think of this video. Any feedback would be greatly appreciated. We're on the road to 25,000 subscribers, and I couldn't do it without any of your guys' help. You guys are the best. I'm having a great day out here. Hopefully, you're having a great day at home. See you all in the next video. Peace.